Today's lecture, we are going to see the types of intake structure. In previous lecture, we have seen water supply scheme components and distribution system. So in this lecture, we are focusing on types of intake structure. What is intake structure? Intake structures are used for collecting water from surface sources such as river, lake, and reservoir and conveying it further to the water treatment plant. As we have already seen in water supply scheme components. So intake is one of the component of water supply scheme as we have already seen. So intakes are generally constructed to intake the water from the source of water, for example from lake, river, and supply this or convey this water to the water treatment plant. So it is a very important component part of water supply scheme. These structures are masonry or concrete structures and provides relatively clean water free from pollution, sand, and objectionable floating material so that we are intaking the water which is free from floating material. So next are the site selection for intake structure. What are the criteria for site selection for intake structure? The site should be so selected that it may admit water even under worst condition of flow in the river. Generally, it is preferred that intake should be sufficiently below the shoreline. Site should be very close to treatment plant as possible so that we can reduce the cost of conveying of pipe water from the pipe. It should be so located that it is free from the pollution. It is better to provide intake at upper stream of city so that water is not contaminated. It should not interfere with river traffic, if any. Next, it should be located where good foundation conditions are available for the construction of intake structures. And it should be so located that it admits relatively pure water free from mud, sand, and other pollutants. Means it should be protected from rapid currents. So these are the some basic criteria or requirements for selection of intake site for intake structure. Next important part is the types of intake structure. So there are different types of intakes which we are going to construct depending on the availability of water and the requirement for further water conveying system to the treatment plant. So intakes are classified under three categories. First is according to the position, the intake should be classified as submerged intake and exposed intake. Then according to presence of water in tower, the intake should be classified as wet intake and dry intake. And according to type of source, the intake should be classified as river intake, reservoir intake, lake intake, and canal intake. So these are the important types of intake. So let's we see one by one. First is depending on its position. First one is submerged intake. What is submerged intake? So according to position, the intake may be classified as submerged intake. The submerged intake structures are those which are constructed entirely under water. So that's why we are called it as submerged intake. They are less expensive to construct but are difficult to maintain because whole structure is underground, under water level. Such intakes are commonly used to obtain water from lakes. So when sufficient water is available in lake which is fulfilling the capacity of treatment plant, then we are constructing the submerged intake. This is a typical diagram of submerged intake. As you can see in this diagram, this is the water level of lake. And intake should be constructed below this ground level and below this water level. And water should be intake from this lake and convey it to the further treatment plant. So as you can see, here is the strainer provided in this intake which is avoid or exclude the floating materials which are coming from this lake or other impurities in form of silt, so that we are removed through this strainer. Next type of intake, depending on its position, is exposed intake. The exposed intake is in the form of well or tower constructed near the bank of river, or in same cases even away from the bank of river. They are more common due to ease in operation and maintenance because the whole structure is the above ground. So these are the typical diagram of construction of exposed intake structure, which are the whole construction is above this water level. So next type is wet intake. So according to presence of water in tower, there are two types, wet intake structure and dry intake structure. Wet intake type of intake. Wet intake is type of intake tower in which the water level is practically the same as the level of source of supply. That means the whole intake is submerged by the water level. It is sometimes known as jack well and it most commonly used. So this is the type of wet intake structure. As you can see, its outlet level of conveying of water is equal to this high flood level of water present in reservoir, river or lake. That means the both the levels are same. So that are called as wet intake. That means is 80% part is below this water level. Next is dry intake. In case of dry intake, there is no water in the water tower. Water enters through entry port directly into the conveying pipe. It is simply used for the operation of valves, etc. So these are the structures of dry intake. So that means that water level, top level or high flood level of water is different and its outlet level of conveying the water is different. So there is difference between these two water levels that are called as dry intake structure. Next, according to the type of source, that is whether we are conveying the water or intaking the water from river or lake or canal, the intake should be classified on the basis of its types of source, that is river intake, canal intake, lake intake, reservoir intake. So let's we see one by one. First is river intake. It is the type of intake which may either located sufficiently inside the river so that demands of water are met within all the seasons of year, or they may be located near the river bank where the sufficient depth of water is available. So these intake structures are constructed under the river. Sometimes an approach channel is constructed and water is led to an intake tower. If the water level in the river is low, a weir may be constructed across it to raise the water level and divert it to the intake tower. So this is the typical structure of intake tower, a river intake tower. As you can see, this is the low water level and this is the high flood level in the river. This is the penstock. So from that, the entry of water is takes place. Screen is provided to avoid the floating and other silt materials. This is suction pipe which sucks the clean water through this pump and convey this water to the treatment plant for its further treatment. So this is the on-field diagram of river intake structure which are constructed on the river bank. Next is reservoir intake. When the flow in the river is not guaranteed throughout the year, a dam is constructed across it to store the water in the reservoir so formed. So there are two conditions. So river intake are constructed on the river bank when and only when the water is available throughout the year. So the reservoir intakes are constructed on the reservoir which we are artificially constructed, or dams are constructed to store the river water when and only when the capacity of river and flow in river are not available throughout the year, then we are constructing these types of reservoir, that is reservoir intake. These are similar to the river intake, except that these are located near the upstream face of the dam where maximum depth of water is available. The design of intake may vary based on the type of dam. So these are the typical diagram of reservoir intake. As you can see, this is the upstream site of dam. So these are the level, that is low level and high flood level. These are the penstocks or intake of pipes, and screens are provided at the entry of this intake so that we are avoiding the entry of floating materials and silt content. Then this water is conveyed through this pipe, which is conveying to the water treatment plant. These are the on-field diagram of reservoir intake structure. Next is lake intake. Generally, submerged intake are preferred for the lake intake. These are constructed at subscribe or bell mouth. The cribes are made up of heavy timber framework, which is partially or wholly filled with riprap to protect the intake conduit against the damage by waves, etc. The top of the cribe is covered with cast iron or mesh grating to avoid the entry of silt particles or any floating materials. So this is the on-field diagram of lake intake, which are constructed on the bank of lake or on the lake. Next are canal intake. In some cases, sources of water supply to a small town may be an irrigation canal passing nearer or throughout the town. Then it will be constructed. Generally, it consists of masonry or concrete intake chamber of rectangular shape, admitting water through the core screen. A fine screen is provided over the bell mouth entry of the outlet pipe for avoiding of silt content or any floating material. The intake chamber may be constructed inside the canal bank if it does not offer any appreciable resistance to the normal flow in the canal. It's preferred to provide lining to the canal near the intake chamber for avoiding its leakage. This is the typical diagram of canal intake structure. The component parts are same, only the difference is these intakes are constructed on the bank of canal.